dia, good afternoon, good evening, guys, wherever you are in this beautiful world. Whenever you're watching this video, welcome to the Bitcoin Family YouTube channel for the newcomers. My name is Diri Tayutu. Yes, I am the dad of the Bitcoin family that has been traveling around the world for 4 years now after going all into Bitcoin. Yes, we sold our house, our companies, literally everything we owned. We went all into Bitcoin and started traveling the world. We have been discovering Portugal from our base in Lagos in an apartment like 200 meters that way. It's like a 2 minute walk. In today's video, as you're used on Monday, mainly about Bitcoin and charting, because I already did a YouTube show early this morning with Sean from Hardforking and Lisa and Edwards. And of course, I'm going to add that part of the show into today's video as well. So today, mainly charts. I'm going to bomb you with crazy, cool Bitcoin charts, probably a few you have never seen before. So enjoy today's video, guys. Start, guys, with the family part. This one, bam! Will be a very short part because, you know, I only want to tell you that we as a family are still discovering Portugal, but we don't know if we can continue the whole tour we have planned at the moment. Because at the moment, more and more countries are closing down their borders again and all that stuff because of this flu situation that, to be very clear, I just think it's a normal flu. Every seasonal flu happens around this period. So I think we don't experience this drastic killer virus. I think we are experiencing again this seasonal flu. So I don't understand why all these countries are now closing the borders, even here in Portugal, talking about closing the borders. So our goal was to drive through Portugal, Spain, another few other countries to arrive at one of the main sponsors of this tour, machinatrader.com. We just don't know how everything is going to evolve in the next couple of weeks, so we will just go with the flow. At the end, the goal will not change, but maybe it will take a little bit longer before we leave Portugal into those other countries, which also is really positive because Portugal is an amazing country and there is so much more to discover for us. And today again, guys, I'm hiding a QR code in this video. So if you find the QR code, scan the QR code, claim your family tokens. And again, I am not telling you how many family tokens you will find. It's just like a treasure hunt. You never know what is inside the treasure. But be honest, it's always cool because it's free. And yes, you can already spend the family tokens at our store or many other options like you can see on Roll. I will share a link to our Roll page down below so you can see what you already can buy with your hard-earned family tokens by watching these videos. Now go find the QR code. That was already the family part. Let's take it to the Bitcoin part where I will bomb you with some really cool Bitcoin charts. This part, bam! And yes, of course, zooming out, as that is what I always prefer to do, let's take a look at a weekly chart, at this one. Bam! On this weekly chart, guys, you can see something huge happened. We just closed a weekly candle above $13,000. The last time we did this was January 2018. That's almost 3 years ago. So it took 3 years for us to close another weekly candle above 13K. As you can see on this chart, this green area, this was the resistance area of 12K. If you look to the left on the chart, you can see how often we tried to break this 12K and we didn't succeed. And after that, we fell down again to lows. Now, we just broke this green area. We closed a weekly candle at $13,000. The next step, in my opinion, will be that we are going to test the 12K region again to show if it is support. So this weekly candle could even close around 12K. Just to test, did we flip the 12K resistance into a 12K support area? And then when that one is positive, so when this next weekly candle will close above the 12K region, guys, that will be a very bullish sign in Bitcoin if it is up to me. But remember guys, it's a weekly chart, so every candle is a week. So this is not something you trade like on a daily basis. This is when you are in this business as an investor and you just hold Bitcoin for the long term. So then it's really cool to zoom out and to see that we just broke this huge resistance level of 12K, even closed the weekly candle above 13K. And now let's see what will happen. Are we going to go up to 14K and then retest this 12K support area? And will 12K be then the support? If 12K then will be the support, man, then I can only say to you guys, we are in the middle of this huge bull run that we have seen every 4 year cycle before. And again, we will repeat this 4 year cycle and we will see a huge increase in the Bitcoin price the next couple of months, guys. And guys, if we zoom a little bit more out, let's take a look at the monthly chart. This one, bam! Wow, that was like in the same moment as the waves. The waves are always important on the charts. So let's take a look at this monthly chart. That was really coincidence, but it was really cool. And again, bam! I'm counting the waves now. Oh my God, the waves are killing me. Look how beautiful. That's so beautiful. Why do I want to look at the monthly chart, guys? Because this monthly close, as you can see on the chart, is a huge monthly close. We just closed the weekly chart above 13K. Are we going to close the monthly chart above 13K as well? If we would be able to close this monthly chart above 13K, this is really bullish, guys. And why do I think that this monthly close is a little bit more special than the other monthly closes? Because this monthly close is falling together with Halloween, a full blue moon, a blue full moon. Check what happened during the last full blue moons with Bitcoin. There are many people in this industry that are charting on the moons and the stars. So check what happened with the last blue moon. But the end of this month, again, guys, sorry. I hope the waves are not disturbing you too much. But at the end of the month, so we have Halloween. We have a monthly close in Bitcoin. We have a full blue moon. We have more than $750 million worth of Bitcoin options that expire. CME open interest expires as well at the end of the month. So everything is falling together around the 30 and the 31st of this month. It's going to be a very important moment for Bitcoin, the close of this monthly candle, together with all these things happening at the end of this month. And guys, before I will jump into the charts that Lisa will share with us, I have one more chart to share with you guys, because I found this one on Twitter, on Bitcoin Jack Twitter, Bitcoin Jack Sparrow Twitter. Let's take a look at this chart. Bam! On this chart, guys, if you look to the bottom of the chart, you can see this green and this orange line. The green line is the 200 daily average. The orange line is the all-time average. Every time in the past, when we saw this green line crossing above this orange line, so the 200 day average crossing above the all time average, we saw a huge run in Bitcoin. If you look to the left on the chart, that way, you can see what happened in 2012 and what happened in 2016. To be exactly what happened in November 2012. If you look on the chart to the left and you look to this vertical line coming down in November 2012, that was the moment the green line started to move above the orange line. What happened to the Bitcoin price? Bam, it went up. Now look to the next vertical line, July 2016. The green line crossing the orange line, going to move above the orange line. What happened to the Bitcoin price? Bam, all the way up to 20K. And now look to today. What do you see on the chart? You can see that this green line again started to cross the orange line upwards. So if we are going to repeat the same movement we saw in 2012 and 2016, what do you think that will happen with the Bitcoin price? My opinion, bam, up. And again, bam, up. That is what I think is going to happen if you look at these charts. So that was all the charting for me today. So now let's jump into Lisa's TA. Lisa, show me your charts. Bam.
Okay, sounds good.
Trading you on Prime XBT at the moment. That's looking nice and healthy again. Thanks once again to the people at Prime.
Yeah, don't copy trade me. Copy trade number one. Apparently, he made 2,500% in like 10 days or something.
He's in love.
Right. What's the love heart there?
That's my sell point. That's where I love to make money.
Ah.
Yeah, so I'm manifesting Bitcoin and money. So, like, I've got this manifestation at the moment that every time I spend money, I make 10 times the money. So every time I spend even $5, I say to myself, every time I spend money or crypto, I make 10 times the money. So then I have a really good trade. And that's what's been happening. So I'm manifesting it. So at the moment, we're in this channel, we're in this third wave, but we're in a retrace of this third wave at the moment. So we could go down. We've got a smaller channel within this channel, and we've got a 12,400-ish sort of mark here on this channel. So if we have a look back through, we kind of do move about $300 to $400 when we are in a retrace. So we've gone from 12,100 to, well, that's a bit more. So that's about $1,000 retrace there. So we could get a deeper retrace. It can possibly retrace here to about 11,600. That doesn't break the pattern. You know, we could even go down and touch this channel support, so which is 11,300. So, like I said last week, I've got an order there waiting just in case. But I really think we're pretty bullish right now. So, you know, it's not picking up a lot of orders right at the moment. So 12,000 sort of 300 ish is kind of the move that I'm seeing over the next sort of week. And we'll probably go up and retest the sort of the 13,000 sort of 400-ish mark and do that sort of region over the next week to 2 weeks and before we move off. And then again, we could just get these stimulus checks in the USA and it might just explode. So that's the other option. So we could go straight up. So my target here on the channel resistance is 14,605, and we could very well just break through that depending on how much money comes into the market with those stimulus checks. So it's looking really good. So if we have a look at the BTC dominance, it is like literally through the roof. So we went up to 76 with that big explosion that we had the other day, and we've dropped back down. We're back within this channel, which is a good position. When we're in this channel here, it's a good place to be buying alts and to be short-term trading the alts. So it wouldn't be long-term
BTC
trading.
BTC dominance went up to 76%?
Yeah, with that big move.
Wow.
Yeah. So when we had that big move the other day, so if we go back to this chart, so when we had this big green dildo, we went up to 76% on the dominance chart, so it's like massive. Yeah. But what I was trying to show you over the last couple of weeks as well, we had these resistance tests on this chart, which TradingView did clean up, but they were happening. So which means when we're getting resistance tests on charts, it usually means we're in for a big move, and that was happening a lot on the week prior to that massive big candle that we saw. So for anyone that was saying that we were going down and we were doing those gaps, is like they're still saying, but anyway, we're not doing gaps. Can we do ethereum? So for the 500th time, so we should not, that we're still in this very bullish formation, but we haven't tested or retested MAs for quite some time. So I really feel both BTC and Ethereum have MA tests coming. So the MA on Ethereum is 395. It will probably be a really quick wick to this region. It's actually like all charts are still super bullish, and there's still a lot of sort of, you know, money coming into the market and holding these regions up. So if it does drop, it's going to be a quick drop and it'll bounce quite hard. So I would have, we've got 384 as the 200 MA and 395 as the 100 MA here. So I'd have a couple of strategic orders in those areas if it does drop. And yeah, so the channel here, which I don't think it's going to go down to, is 369. But we should hold, we could actually, because this is the one wave, so it could actually drop down to the channel, which is interesting when I look at that. So maybe a strategic order around the 368 mark in case.
Interesting week. I mean, Ethereum has outperformed Bitcoin this year, but Bitcoin really lifted in the dust recently, which I find interesting.
The volume of Ethereum is like, I think, the first currency that will surpass $1 trillion US dollar volume in a year. Like Bitcoin has always led the volume chart, and this year Ethereum is leading, I think, with almost 1 trillion, and Bitcoin is still around 800 million or something. But that's huge.
So it's massive, and I think that's mainly due to what's happened in the DeFi sort of sector. Of course. So we've got the Litecoin chart, which has had a really strong move. So we've got quite a few resistances that we've broken through on Litecoin. So we've got this white one, which is there for quite some time. So, and then we had a horizontal resistance. So this one's broken through a cross resistance, which means if it does come down, it's not going below 49. I don't think it's going to come down. So we've got this other diagonal resistance here, which is 54. So we could see a correction down to 54 at this point, or we could see it down to 49. I still think a lot of these charts are correcting over the next sort of couple of days before we have another bigger move. You can see that Litecoin predominantly moves in what we call head and shoulders. So we've got the head and shoulders here, we've dropped. So head and shoulders here, we've dropped. So we'll probably get some sort of head and shoulders pattern forming. So it could come down here, up here, down here, sort of, and yeah. It won't go that low, just to give all the Litecoin people a heart attack.
I know you two know a lot of Litecoin people, and it's actually a project I want to review on my Wednesday show, because I've never really put a lot of time into learning about Litecoin, but I'd love to do that on that show. So anyone watching from Litecoin?
This is Elrond, yeah, or now eGold, so rebranded and re-added. So this one almost hit my stop. I'm very happy it didn't. So we should see a little bit of sideways at this point, and then we should continue up. We want to get above this resistance here and then hold above that resistance so that we can continue up. So potentially this chart has a 200% move from this bottom region coming, and you know, this is in line with obviously Bitcoin moving and you know, all the charts moving and a lot more money coming into the market over the next little bit. So so we want to get above this resistance, hold above the resistance, and then continue up at that point.
Okay.
So Ava is one that I've had on Twitter, and it's in my buy zone. So reason being, the visual range profile has, you know, the volume range profile has got lots of support in this region, and we're in here, and I really believe that this is the time to be buying this. So they've got a lot of stuff happening, a lot of developments, and, you know, RSI here has consolidated. We're on the diagonal support on the RSI. So potentially in this region, we've got a 320% move. I'll quickly look at DOT because I know lots of people on Twitter are trading. So we're in this sideways wedge, which will break. Usually a wedge like this will break up. So our $7.50-ish sort of target on DOT is still there. It's moving terribly, terribly slow. So obviously the excitement and everything is worn off, and, you know, all the stuff that's happening in the background is taking a little bit longer. So, you know, sort of, you know, not so much trading happening right now on DOT, but it's still moving in the right direction.
No closing comments. I just love the show. I love to be part of the show. I'm happy that Lisa is still part of the show. I'm very much, much looking forward to a live show, so you cannot cut out all the stuff that you always cut out, like Naked Men and all the stuff.
We don't actually cut it.
Yeah, like every time Sean had Naked Men walking through, and it's like I'm starting to wonder, maybe...
My flatmate and his daughter, you mean, yeah.
It was like Sean's male Tinder dates. Sorry, Kathy, Sean's gay. Not that there's anything wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with that.
No, no. That's not nothing. We don't, you know, we know that you've lived in Thailand for a long time, happy long time. But, so I just want to wish everybody an amazing week. And I just, you know, zoom out and enjoy the beautiful ride of Bitcoin again.
I really hope you enjoy Lisa's charts. I always love how Lisa explains her charts, and she has been right many times. So indeed, we could go all the way up to 14,600, fall down to this 12K region to test support, and then again go up to 16K or 20K or even 100K next years. Let's see what will happen, but I prefer to zoom out in Bitcoin and to zoom in at life. The last part of the video will be, of course, about the blockchain/news. Don't have that much news. The only thing I want to talk to you guys about is NFT collectibles. Do you guys know what NFT collectibles are? If I want to translate it to something in the past that you were used to do, let's take a look at, for example, Panini. Panini was the soccer cards. You had this book, and then you needed to collect these cards and paste them in this book, and then you had all the soccer players, and you had different cards. A few of these cards were more exclusive than the other ones. They were the shiny cards. These were the old collectibles, not the digital one, but the physical one. And after that, we had many more of these collectibles, of course. We had not only the soccer cards, but we also had the Pokemon cards, and we had all the Warrior game cards, and all that stuff that was what they call collectibles. And collectibles fall under the group of NFTs, non-fungible tokens. A non-fungible token is a very unique, exclusive token that is representing something very unique. For example, in the physical world, you have a Picasso painting. There is only one original Picasso painting, and we know that. But we don't know this for sure, of course, because there are many fakes and many copies, but there is one very original Picasso painting. This new world, this new virtual world, we have the same thing. But these are non-fungible tokens built on the blockchain. So we definitely know that they are unique. The Mona Lisa, we don't know for sure if it's an original. We probably know for sure, but not like 100%. An NFT minted on the blockchain, we can very transparent see that that is the original one that was minted onto the blockchain. So these NFTs are going to be huge. And especially, guys, these collectibles, because these collectibles are these unique things that the youth wants to have. The youth wants to have very cool digital cards, you know. We already saw the success of Blockchain Heroes by Joel Kahn from the Bad Crypto podcast. This one, they created really cool blockchain hero charts. Everybody wants to collect them, and they get a value. And the more exclusive they are, the higher the value will be, and people will start to exchange these cards in a digital way. Not physical cards, but digital cards. Then by checking your Ethereum address, you can see which collectibles or which NFTs are owned by that address. And you are the owner of that address again. So I am stepping into this world as well, because I'm educating myself so I can educate you. But I have something really cool upcoming this week, because I'm able to give away some really, really cool and very unique collectibles this week. It's a really cool free giveaway that I'm going to do of really cool collectibles, of which I don't even know if you want to exchange them, because they are like way too cool. So maybe you end up huddling them instead of exchanging them for value. And guys, of course, talking about collectibles, let's take, for example, my t-shirts. This one, Bitcoin Generation X. I am mine on the 26th of May in 78. Is this a collectible? Normally, I would say no, because we sell many more of the same t-shirt that I'm selling. But this one could be referred as, because you can change your text. My text, guys, is mined 26th of May in 78. You can adjust this text on your t-shirt. So you can make your own t-shirt out of this Bitcoin Generation X t-shirt. And the moment you create something really unique, and there is only one of them in the world, then it's a collectible. Buy this t-shirt, adjust the text, and you're the proud owner of a really cool collectible, in my opinion. But then, it's still up to the market what they want to pay for this very unique item. And that is what makes this whole NFT industry really cool, guys. That was everything for today, guys. I hope you really enjoyed the video. If you did enjoy the video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, share it with your friends and community, hit the notification bell, and please leave a comment, as I love to respond to your comments. I want to thank you for watching today's video, and always remember to zoom out in crypto and to zoom in at life. Try to enjoy every single minute of the day, as that is exactly what life is about. Thanks for watching, and hopefully see you tomorrow again, and I will try to get one of the family members aboard again, Jolie, Juna, Jessa, or Roman. But guys, have an amazing day, and hopefully see you tomorrow again. Bye.